I'm Norman Wildberger, and this is a new series that's going to explore the foundations of modern mathematics in a new and better way. I'm a research mathematician at the University of New South Wales in Sydney, Australia. I'm also the discoverer of rational trigonometry. The aims of this series are primarily three. I want to expose some of the weaknesses that currently exist in set theory, in analysis, and in various other related areas of mathematics, including geometry. I want to also lay a new foundation for mathematics, a framework which makes sense, which doesn't rely on authority, doesn't rely on various unsubstantiated axiomatic systems, one that anyone can understand who wants to follow from the beginning. The third aim is I want to provide a resource for teachers, for public school teachers, and for high school teachers. I want to explain the subject in a way that people developing curriculum can have a basis for making rational decisions about what to include and what not to include. Now, this will not be a course in mathematics. I'm interested in laying the foundations, but not on building elaborate theories. So I'm going to go around and we're going to look at various topics and ask ourselves what are really the essential notions here, what are the main definitions, how they fit into place correctly. When mathematics is done right, all the blocks do fit together really well. It's not artificial. Things really do work out. And this is going to be the test for us that we're really doing things in the right way. So our main principles that we'll follow is that we're going to start right from the beginning. We're not going to assume that you already have a PhD in set theory and logic. We're not going to assume a lot of sophistication, a lot of jargon. We're going to start from the beginning. The first steps are usually the most important ones in any journey, and it's especially true when developing mathematics. You have to start from the beginning, and you have to start in a simple way. So we are going to keep things simple and natural. We're going to try to connect with the real world at all times. And finally, we're going to keep an open mind. We're not going to just accept the usual orthodoxy because people tell us. And we're also going to be prepared that we don't have the final say. That we may be prepared to revisit what we have already done in later videos and come back and think about things in slightly different ways if necessary. So how are we going to start? We're going to start with the most important subject in mathematics, the most important objects in mathematics. The most important mathematical objects are the natural numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. These have obviously been around for hundreds of thousands of years. And as we develop them from first principles, let's not get too sophisticated. The starting point is an empty page. Nothing. This is how we start mathematics. We start with nothing. Now we want to introduce something. There is our symbol for something. It represents a single entity, and we'll call it one. So we have had nothing before, now we have a single entity, which we're calling one. It's a stroke on the paper. We could also represent it with a dot or a circle or something else, but let's agree it's a little vertical stroke. Then the next idea is the idea of adding one to itself. One and another one. That makes a number which we'll call two. And then we can iterate, we can keep on adding one to what we've already got to get a sequence of objects, which we'll call at this point 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and so on, whose names will be 3, 4, 5, and so on. So we do not assume yet the Arabic-Hindu notational system that we're all used to, because that's a much more sophisticated idea. So currently, what a natural number is just a string of ones. So let's write that down as a main definition. A natural number is a string of ones. Mathematical objects are all going to be based on natural numbers. These are our first mathematical objects, and it will turn out that everything else that we do will ultimately be based on natural numbers. So, a few observations. The natural numbers form a sequence. They are naturally ordered. To every natural number, we can associate the next one, which we might call the successor. So we can say that the successor of 1 is 1, 1, or 2. The successor of 2 is 3, and so on. So this is a notion of successor. It's our first example of a mathematical operation. We take a number, its successor is another number. So my daughter loves Littlest Pet Shops, and there are dozens of these little things lying around our house. And so here are a bunch of Littlest Pet Shops. Suppose we want to count how many there are. Well, what we do is, the first one, we make a stroke. For the next one, we make a stroke. Next one, stroke. Next one, a stroke. And the next one, another stroke. And we then say that the number of Littlest Pet Shops was 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, which we also call 5. So we have the natural numbers. We have the natural successor function. The other important concept that's really elementary is the notion of relative size. Which one is bigger, which one is less smaller. So if we have two numbers, say that one and that one, then to compare those two numbers, in other words to find out which one comes first in the sequence, what we do is we think about pairing the ones in each sequence. Let me see, we've paired up the elements, the ones in the first string with some of the ones in the second string, and we have some left over. This tells us that the second one is larger than the first number. So we have a notion of bigger than. Now let's introduce a little bit of abstract notation. Let's represent a natural number, which we'll just call a number, by a letter. So it's a general thing. For example, N or M. So now we can say that N equals M. By that we mean that the ones in N can be paired up with the ones in M. That's the notion of equality, when two numbers are the same. And we also have a notion of inequality. We say that N is less than M, which that means that, well, N comes before M in the sequence of natural numbers. Now that we have what the natural numbers are, the next step is to think about arithmetical operations on natural numbers. Addition, multiplication, subtraction, and division. That's what we're going to do with our next video. I hope you'll join me. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.